This is an Ion Annapolis sports update.
Hey there, this is John Frenay with Ion Annapolis, coming to you live from Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium on a beautiful Saturday afternoon. It is August 31st. We have Navy football with their home opener with a kickoff time of 3:30 against Holy Cross. Currently, Navy is favored by 21 points in this game, but we'll never know how that works out until the game is actually played. The two schools have never played together, so there's not a lot of reconnaissance between the two, but Navy is coming off of a two-game loss last year with a heartbreaking third loss to Army and the Army-Navy game of 17-10 up in Philadelphia, while Holy Cross is coming off of a four-game winning streak. Again, with this being the home opener, the reset button has been pushed, and we will see what happens. As far as the game time festivities go, the march on, this is the Brigade of Midshipmen, and if you have never seen this, you really do need to attend a Navy football game and check this out, but this is when the entire brigade of approximately 3,500 midshipmen will march from the Naval Academy up to the stadium in formation up onto the field prior to taking their seats. That gets underway at 3:12. There will be a military flyover at 3:21 with a parachute jump at 3:25. Halftime, they are going to have a video honoring former head coaches George Welsh and Rick Verzano, who passed away in the recent year. And if you are here at the stadium, you'll notice that there is the number 27 painted on the field at the 27-yard lines on both sides of the field, and that is in honor of Joe Bellino, who died back in March, and he is the first Navy player to win a Heisman Trophy, as well as the first Navy player to have his number retired. Bellino was a native of Winchester, Massachusetts, and was known as the player who was never caught from behind, and in just three seasons, he scored 31 touchdowns, rushed for 1,664 yards on 333 carries, returned 37 kicks for 833 yards, and set 15 school records. All eyes this season are going to be on Malcolm Perry, who is the starting quarterback for Navy. If you will remember, back in 2016, Perry was actually plucked from the stands. He did not dress for a game as a freshman because of an injury to Tago Smith, was sent to the locker room, asked to dress, and over the next 4 years, he really has developed into a force. He was named co-captain of the team along with Paul Carruthers, Nizir Cromartie, and Ford Higgins, and he was permanently named the starter last year against SMU, where he led the team for a win 43-40. That was followed, unfortunately, by a loss to Army up in Philadelphia, as well as Virginia Tech in the Military Bowl. The other one to watch this season is going to be head coach Ken Niumatalolo. After the season last year, which can only be described as an implosion, he shook up the coaching staff, brought in some new talent, refined some of the old talent, and really shook up the program. Again, first game of the season, we'll see how it does. The Navy tailgates are in full swing out in the parking lot, and the crowds are starting to filter in now. We are about an hour and 10 minutes from kickoff at this point when I'm recording this. We will update this at the end of the quarters and the end of the game. I do suggest you follow us on Twitter at IonAnnapolis as well, because we will be updating that as we move along. We'll have photos from the field a little bit later on tonight, or possibly tomorrow morning, depending on how quickly we can get them edited and put up. I also suggest that you subscribe to our daily news brief, which comes to you every morning at 7 a.m., bringing you all the local news and weather you can use for the Annapolis and Anne Arundel area. You can subscribe for free anywhere you get your podcasts, Apple Podcasts, Google Play, or any of the other podcatchers that are out there. And make sure you're checking out IonAnnapolis.net all the time for all the local news and events. That's about it from the pregame here at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium, where Navy is set to take on Holy Cross in just about an hour and 10 minutes. This is John Frenay with Ion Annapolis, and for now, go Navy.
This has been an update from Ion Annapolis. Please visit us at IonAnnapolis.net. Follow us on Twitter at IonAnnapolis. And be sure to subscribe to our daily news brief podcast, which is delivered every Monday through Friday to your phone or device at 7 a.m.